The following is a W2M Network feature presentation of Life is Like a Game Show. And here's your host moderator, Harry Broadhurst.
Say goodbye to what we had. The good time that made us laugh.
Good evening, good afternoon, whenever you happen to be listening, and welcome to a special presentation of Life is Like a Game Show as we pay tribute to the fallen Gilbert Gottfried. John Hurst, joining me as per usual, are your co-hosts, Eric Watkins, Jonathan Nielsen, and Brian Espinoza. Gentlemen, man, 2022 has not been kind to celebrities early.
I mean,
all right, we can close the Boys to Men.
Dare we say a sequel to 2020 in that regard? And 2016. Oh.
We don't need another one of those.
Your microphone is not turned on, Brian.
Your phone is not turned. Oh yeah, hey.
Yeah, now it's on.
Now it's on. This is what happens when I double mute when I, you know, try to do my, horrible Boys to Men impersonation.
Hey, Brian.
What?
In fitting today, I have to say it. You fool.
As Toby already mentions,
Gottfried, not Godfrey, Gottfried.
Gottfried. Or to me, and I'm pretty sure Mr. Watkins knows this already. Eric, what's my favorite Disney movie?
Aladdin.
He was Iago the parrot.
Iago.
Yeah.
Also on the PBS Kids long running side bridge chase, Gidget the Boy.
He was also in Beverly Hills Cop 2. Anything you want, officer. Anything you want. How much is it going to take for me to get out of this parking situation?
Okay, other than the reverb there, that was actually.
And honestly, if we're also going that far,
Jonathan's was better.
Needless to say that he was the first to voice whenever you look to a certain insurance company that always paid you in cash, Aflac!
Indeed, the original voice of the Aflac duck. But since this is Life is Like a Game Show, we are obviously going to focus more on his... I cannot see what that says.
Gilbert Gottfried's amazing, yes. Colossal podcast.
His Gilbert impression is actually really good. I got to give him this one. All right. So since this is a game show podcast, however, we are going to focus the majority of our coverage tonight on arguably the most iconic moment of the Whoopi Goldberg version of Hollywood Squares.
One of the most iconic game show moments of all history.
Indubitably.
And in this particular episode of Hollywood Squares, which I'm sure we will show most, if not all of it, because we are not monetizing this episode.
All the pertinent parts.
You will see that this is quite literally the Gilbert Gottfried half hour.
Now, before we go to the...
Let's go to the academic, the non-credible academic.
I was going to say the same thing, except Harry seems to be... Yeah, Harry seems to be on quite a bit of a delay this evening.
But all my voices...
I'm going to restart my site.
But yes, please.
All right, let's try this.
Nielsen, would you take it away?
We now go to Jonathan Nielsen with the non-credible academic.
Thank you, Mr. Broadhurst. And yes, I'm going to do my Gilbert Gottfried voice for the entire read because I can. Gilbert Jeremy Gottfried, on February
20th. When do you mute your microphone?
It's already muted.
1955.
Better.
And lost him today, April 12th, 2022, at the age of 67. Career as an actor, stand-up comedian, singer, and musician. Standing at a mere 5'5", married to Dara Kravitz since 2007, has a sister, Arlene, and has a website, GilbertGottfried.com. As a comedian, Gilbert Gottfried was known to push the envelope just a little too far sometimes. Definitely more on the lewd side of humor, and evidenced in 1991 at the 43rd Primetime Academy Awards. He made an endless series of masturbation jokes in reference to Paul Reubens's arrest for masturbating in an adult movie theater. Viewers on the East Coast saw the whole entire set live, but of course, Fox, being the people they are, censored the broadcast for the West Coast delay. Fox issued an apology, stating that Gottfried's jokes were irresponsible and insulting. Gottfried said producers stated they were not invited back. Rolling Stone even wrote that the monologue resulted in him blacklisted.
You can bet on Bovada for that, Patrick.
21 means 21, goddammit.
Obey all local gambling laws. Please gamble responsibly.
Well played, gentlemen. Well played.
Now, but wait, it gets worse. This is something I personally do not agree with, being a fellow New Yorker like Mr. Gottfried was. During his monologue at a Friars Club roast of Hugh Hefner, 3 weeks after 9/11, Gottfried joked that he intended to catch a plane, but he couldn't get a direct flight because they had to stop off at the Empire State Building first. Boo, too soon. Realizing that he had lost the audience bigger than anybody has ever lost an audience, Gilbert then abandoned his remarks and launched into the venerable aristocrat's joke and won back the audience. Of course, Penn Jillette of Penn Sunday School Podcast and his good friend Paul Prevenza used Gilbert's monologue as a segment in their 2005 film, The Aristocrats. And then, of course, because Gilbert Gottfried doesn't know where to stop pushing the envelope, in March 2011, he made a series of jokes on his Twitter about the earthquake disaster in Japan. Aflac, which does 75% of its business in Japan, dismissed him as the duck mascot, and he was then replaced by somebody doing a Gilbert Gottfried impersonation almost on par with mine. To wrap things up, ventricular tachycardia. I can't do it in his voice, damn it. Recurrent ventricular tachycardia compounded by a type 2 myotonic dystrophy. We lost Gilbert Gottfried in Manhattan at the prime age of 67 years old. And goddamn, there's a lot of stuff in his filmography. Somebody, please, take it away.
Okay, first of all, can we just give credit for dedication to the bit there?
That one segment is we've gotten the most comments on our podcast than we've gotten pretty much ever.
And I don't
do many good voices, but what I do, the voices are spot on.
We will get to We will get to the Hollywood Squares moment in a few seconds here. Eric, real quick, your lasting memories of Gilbert Gottfried.
Honestly, and this was mentioned, Fonty brought this up. I was someone who loved both the Problem Child movies.
Correct me if I'm wrong. That was the one with John Ritter, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
And especially Problem Child 2, where he was the principal and he wound up skipping him ahead so he wouldn't have to deal with him. Just
Mr.
That.
Peabody.
Hey, thank you, Mr. Peabody. I mean, outside of Hollywood Squares, that was my just incredible favorite moment. That and his appearance on Cosby, where it was the episode all about getting on David Letterman.
Jonathan, save your voice. Do this as Jonathan Nielsen. Same question.
Now that I'm out of character, my favorite Gilbert Gottfried. I'm looking at this list. Man.
He's got quite the resume behind him.
It's got to be after Aladdin and his little bit in Beverly Hills Cop 2 in the 80s, which is, I think, where I first spotted him. I didn't get into the Problem Child movies. That wasn't my shtick. But when it came to Return of Jafar, Aladdin, the King of Thieves, those. And really, it was at that point when The Aristocrats came out that I discovered just his stand-up. And that was what sucked me in. Sure, you got those SNL reboots from the early 80s. You've got, who remembers Duckman? Yeah. 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 He was even, oh, this I got to go back and watch because I didn't realize this was the case. 2002, he voiced himself Gottfried in the Arena on the most awesome claymation series of all time, Celebrity Deathmatch.
I feel like we're going to have to find that clip in order to share that as well, because that feels
even did voices like, on Family Guy and the Weird Al Show.
Game show with Jason, I feel. I specifically remember seeing him appear on Family Guy before. We cannot air a Family Guy clip because we will get copywritten by Fox Media. They can be some assholes. However, I do if you want to, you can search for the clip yourself on YouTube. Okay, we get it, air traffic controller Espinoza.
The standards and practices of the network says, oh fuck, oh hell no. You fool!
All right. I'm actually looking at his filmography myself right now. Same question to you, Espinoza. Favorite Gilbert Gottfried memory?
Excuse me. I scowl with frustration at myself in a mirror. Damn my hair. It just won't behave. And damn Catherine Cavanaugh for being ill and subjecting me to this sword deal. I should be studying for my final exams, which are next week, yet here I am trying to brush my hair into submission. That is the opening line from 50 Shades of Grey, which Gilbert Gottfried
did an audiobook version
of. And I believe that this is a topic we must cover on Point of Viewer, if not play the audio of, this week on Point of Viewer.
Oh, not just that, but what he did for Last Week Tonight for John Oliver to get around other laws in the UK about not using scenes from Parliament on a humorous show. Yeah, we're going to cover those.
Because it's too easy for me to just sit here and go, smoke and fog.
Smoke and fog! Sorry.
Thank you. At least one of y'all got it.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, you'll find out.
You fool!
Yeah, you fool! Because you'll find out in about 10 minutes.
Okay, I think the general consensus amongst our listening audience is that Jonathan's is better.
And the fact that you better have something to drink with you, Andy.
Yeah, get some water, Jonathan.
He's got a drink. He had a drink. He's got a drink.
Yes. Which will be featured on the latest episode of the Nielsen ratings, May 1st.
Side note, we cannot be bought, but we can damn sure be rented.
No.
Different
no.
beverage. That's saved for June.
Ah.
Somebody else had to get their review of it in first.
That beverage possibly being featured this week on Point of Viewer's Drink Review.
All right, let's get off of the plugs and back to the conversation at hand. Do I even need to tell you guys mine? I literally just mentioned it earlier in the show.
I mean, you, Aladdin, Iago, I mean, yeah we kind of, you made it obvious.
Legitimately my favorite movie, my favorite Disney movie of all time. And like, I don't own a ton of DVDs. Eric will tell you I am not a huge DVD person. I have the deluxe diamond edition DVD version of Aladdin.
I watched it 13 times. I was younger.
I used to have the VHS, but this was the one, like, you remember the Disney DVD of the Month Club?
Vaguely.
My sister specifically signed up for the DVD of the Month Club in order to get me the special edition of Aladdin as a Christmas gift.
What that nice of her.
All right, so with that being said, in our own personal favorite memories here, as I said, this is a game show podcast. And no Gilbert Gottfried retrospective on a Gilbert Gottfried podcast would be complete without the Hollywood Squares with Whoopi Goldberg, with host Tom Bergeron, and this particular episode featuring Gilbert Gottfried. Do we have the clip ready, or do we need a second in order to get it? You are on the ball, Watkins.
I sent him the link before we even hit the studio.
Mm-hmm. He did.
We are on the ball. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, the comedic stylings, Gilbert Gottfried.
But first, the setup with Penn and Teller. You're still in this
one, guys. Penn and Teller for the win.
Penn and Teller. MGM Grand Las Vegas, September 30th through October 4th. Holy sure are.
I think we kind of have to do commentary over this in order to keep from getting DMCA'd. For years, the Loftus
Novelty Supply Company and wouldn't necessarily matter. Of them,
what are they? Never mind all that.
Okay.
Pick a card. Just tell me when to stop. Tell me when to stop.
I'll tell you when to stop.
Stop. You need to.
Okay, go.
Right there. Okay, there's the card it is.
All right, looks like.
There's the card. You sure don't say it aloud,
sorry,
stupid.
Of course not. All right.
There it is right there. We've got it. And now I will give it one shuffle and it will appear miraculously in the air. Watch this. And, okay, wait a second. Tell us, could you help me out here? And is this your card? The Three of Clubs.
That's so
clubs.
Freaky. The Three of Clubs.
That's disturbing.
Now you ask me.
That's Penn and Teller.
Only place you can get it.
We have a mnemonic device sitting right below us.
Yes.
A very good mnemonic device. It is the whoopee cushion.
Ooh, wee.
There's the whoopee cushion.
Ooh, wee. A cow.
Agree.
You fool. You fool.
The rubber,
I'm lying to
rubber
you.
Chicken.
The rubber chicken. Look at me. I'm a liar. Look at me.
Magicians are liars. It's part of the job.
Valium level 3.
God damn it. Gilbert Gottfried. For a 5-square win. Gilbert, Playgirl Magazine's clinical sexologist, says, I think we should be able to talk about sex the way we talk about what?
Soft-boiled eggs, because they don't take under 3 minutes.
In 3 minutes?
No, I know this one because I pose for Playgirl. You don't actually see anything because my thumb was in the way.
Ah!
going to say food.
I'll disagree.
Food. All right. Now, here's what happens in a case like this. We could have a five square win that you could pull off, Valerie, by picking the only square left. But we'll have to wait and find out how you do right after this. Stay there.
And the commercials and stuff have been cut out.
To maybe the longest first $1,000 game we've ever had. Valerie going for a five square win here. Where are you going?
Gilbert Gottfried for the win.
Surprise. Okay. Gilbert, in a poll, 94% of Hungarians compared to only 46% of Americans said doing this was necessary to feel fulfilled. Doing what?
Seeing Wayne Newton live. having a child.
I disagree.
You fool!
having a child is correct, David.
Oh,
David? Gilbert Gottfried. Gilbert Gottfried.
You're so popular.
All right, Gilbert.
He loves it.
Here we go. This happened first season, too, didn't it? When she heard that Phileas Fogg had done it in 80 days, journalist Nellie Bly beat him by doing it in 72 days. What did she do?
Get through to the cable company. No, I know this. Trust me.
Trust me.
This is rowing the Atlantic.
I'm going to agree.
You fool!
She went around the world in 72 days. If you're just tuning in, welcome to the Gilbert Gottfried Show.
Gilbert Gottfried for the win!
Its French designer named it the Atom because of its small size and the explosive effect a woman would have when she wore it. Today, it's better known as...
It's in my pants!
But your thumb's covering it.
Yeah. In fact, it's covering it right now.
Boy.
The tube top.
I agree.
You fool!
Bergeron looks ready to walk off set right here and right now.
Bergeron looks like, give me a fucking drink.
He was the one who asked for Valium.
1908 have if you were a Chicago Cubs fan?
That's the year you were in Chicago. Okay. It's the last perfect pitch game.
I'm gonna agree.
You fool!
At the time, this is correct.
Naturally, by the time it happened again, the show's already off the air.
Oh, four?
They won a World Series, so Valerie, we're going to take a commercial break, and we'll be right back with more of the Gilbert Gottfried Hour.
That's five incorrects and four you fools thus far. For those of you keep a count, huh?
Or here in the studio.
Biography's tribute to Gilbert Gottfried. Valerie, your turn.
Gilbert Gottfried for the win.
For the win.
You fool!
All right, Gilbert. Steve Austin. Steve Austin is a big, bad professional wrestler fully known as...
Tubby!
What?
No, I know this one.
Yeah.
I used to wrestle with Steve Austin. The Crusher.
The Crusher.
I'll agree.
You fool!
Stone Cold, girl.
Steve Austin. All right, Officer Dave. Gilbert Gottfried for the win.
Gilbert Gottfried for the win.
By the way, if we run out of time during this or any other game, we're all going out for drinks. the word smog comes from what two words?
Smelly fog. No, it's smoke and fog.
Smoke and fog.
I'm going to agree.
Smoke and fog!
Eight times the charm.
By the way, even though we never got to a secret square game today, we'll carry the intended prize over to tomorrow's show. Valerie, we're going to give
fool!
You... Valerie, this was an incredible half hour. We're going to give you five...
And of course, one more for good measure.
One more for the road. I was just about to say that.
Nice to meet you. Officer Dave... You got $1,000. You successfully defended your championship.
Woo! All right, we don't have to watch the bonus game if you don't want to.
Each of our stars.
Because I don't think he picked Gilbert.
Gilbert was not picked. No.
All right. Easily the most iconic moment of the new Hollywood Squares, the Tom Bergeron edition. One of the most iconic moments of Hollywood Squares in general.
Oh, absolutely.
I'm apparently supposed to be sending it over to Brian Espinosa right now.
Way to fail a setup, Harry.
Wow.
Wait, you fool!
Is that a dot ball?
No,
you fool!
No, if anything, that wasn't necessarily a dot ball. Brian,
that was a no ball. That was a no ball.
No! Brian, perfect line, perfect length. Harry just flat out whiffed it. Damn near missed the wickets.
Cricket to the max, coming soon to the W2M network, apparently.
If I have anything to say about it.
God knows you don't see his happy ass enough around here.
You fool.
But.
You fool!
Thank you. Echo Wing. There was something in this again. We love audience engagement for those of you who happen to be watching us live on twitch.tv/w2mnet, facebook.com, and twitter.com/w2mnetwork. One particular moment that you were trying to go for in particular was related to this very comment. OMG, I just saw a memory. He was in a fire safety movie from when I was a kid. Toby saying that. And a certain someone wanted me to set them up for that comment, but a certain someone else being
had their thumb covering it.
Well, yes, but I was going to...
You fool!
And Harry's thumb is covering his mute button.
I think that was worth a monkey. That was excellent timing from Nielsen.
You know what? You know what?
Gilbert Gottfried would be okay with this chicanery.
Yes, he would.
He would.
And that monkey goes to Gilbert Gottfried.
Now, that being said, you were trying to set up for something, but being the awesome senior producer that he is, I was bestowed upon something in the chat that I have ready to queued up.
Yeah, go ahead and play the clip.
I take it he found the video in question.
I already had the video up at the exact same time Toby made the comment, ironically.
Who are you?
See more smoke. Smoke. Detector. The more smoke I see, the more noise I make. And I see more smoke coming from that toaster.
Oh my God. Thanks for warning us, Seymour.
That's my job. I hate smoke. It's disgusting. It gives me a headache. So whenever I see it or smell it, I make this noise to warn you. Because where there's smoke, there may be fire.
Good tip, Seymour.
How many smoke detectors do you have in your home? Count them. Is there one outside your bedroom? There should be. Tell your parents.
Be cool about fire safety. Be cool.
Man, that commercial brings back so many memories.
Oh, man. I remember that jingle.
In the likes of Gilbert Gottfried, the king of too soon jokes, damn, the smoke detector finally died.
He didn't replace the batteries every 6 months.
Give it.
I mean, you set me up for something like that. It's like, that's how you hit a six, Broadhurst.
I got nothing.
Oh, yes, and see, even Toby agreed that that, see, that was
even our audience thought that was a good too soon joke.
Damn it, Toby.
The smoke detector finally died.
All right.
Normally,
at the end of the episodes, we would take the opportunity to plug our own personal information to tell you where you can find us. That doesn't seem appropriate here. So instead, what we will do, going back to the non-credible academic, Mr. Nielsen, what is Gilbert's middle name?
How dare you ask me to look this up after I've already closed the web browser?
Check your
history. Jeremy Gottfried.
Thank you. This special edition of Life is Like a Game Show is dedicated to the memory of Gilbert Jeremy Gottfried, 67. May you rest easy, sir, and thank you for the memories. For Jonathan Nielsen, Brian Espinoza, Eric Watkins, I'm Harry Broadhurst. You have been listening to a special presentation of Life is Like a Game Show here on the W2M Network.